How's it going, guys? I'm guessing you guys are here because of the title. Three Lightroom hacks in 90 seconds. We'll see if I can actually do that. I think it's possible. Let's start that timer. So we moved over to my computer now. To make it easier to find quite a bit of photos, what I do is rate my photos. If you're not too sure what that is, so let me explain. Right here, I clicked on this photo. So if I click in between 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, I can rate the photo from 1 to 5 stars of how much I like it. So let's say I like this photo 4 stars. Let's go 4 stars. Next photo, I really like it. 5 stars. This photo, another 4 stars. Not so much. Let's rate it 1 star. Maybe even 0 stars if I didn't want to edit it. Maybe another 1 star, about a 3 star for that one, 2 star for that one. So let me move over to the filters off. If you come over here and click this button and click rated, it takes all of the other photos away and only brings up the rated ones. So now onto the second hack. This is probably my favorite Lightroom hack I've learned in the previous years. Let's jump back into the computer there. So right here we have a photo that's in Alberta. It was pretty aligned already, but I did adjust it so it doesn't look too aligned. If you guys don't know how to align a photo just using this, it's pretty hard. Like sometimes if it's way too crooked, it's really hard to get it perfectly on the nose. So instead of doing that, you just click this little button here, go along the horizon or any straight line, click it, and now it's perfectly aligned. That tool comes in handy, especially when you're doing landscapes. Not so much during portraits, unless you're trying to get the photo exactly aligned. You can like align it with like the background or something. Number three. If you guys have never heard of presets before, you guys should definitely get out there and start Googling presets. You can find tons of free ones online. Just download them and throw them into your Lightroom, and it saves you quite a bit of time. Let me show you. So if you're not sure what a preset is, it's like a pre-edited photo kind of, but it's just the edits. It's just the sliders over here. So let me go over here and click natural. So you didn't see too much of a change in the photo itself, but over here, all the sliders are now different. If you scroll through these, they do change. I really like this one because it gives it kind of like a moody look, and it is called matte. So you click on matte, you get a photo like this. I think it's a little too dark, so if I take away a bit of the blacks and up the shadows, not too much, maybe add some clarity in there. If you just click previous, that's what it looked like compared to now. Presets are an amazing tool, especially if you're in a hurry. Most of the time when you're editing photos, you shouldn't be in a hurry, but sometimes it does happen. So if you already have presets made, you can just easily throw them up there and your photos should be much quicker to edit. Thanks for watching this video, guys. If you guys found this useful in any way, shape, or form, give it a like. Subscribe to this channel because I'm hopefully going to be posting videos weekly. Also follow my Instagram. I post quite a bit and quite frequently on there. I also ask in my story for people's opinions on what I should do next for my next video. But thanks for watching. Peace.